We all know that computer programming is heavily based on mathematics, but how far down the rabbit hole have you gone? For loops, one of the most essential loops that we use on a daily basis for iterating through a collection and many other uses, for loops can be done as low level as assembly and as high level as you want to go, such as Python. They may look different in the way that they are presented with each programming language, but the basis for them is exactly the same. What do I mean by this? First, let's take a look at a few examples of for loops. In assembly, we can really see the math show because we are moving data within the registers. Whilst I cannot run this assembly code as shown in the video because it requires NASM and I have MASM, we do have the option of using Tutorials Point and using their NASM online compiler, and we can see the result from this very same code. So why am I bringing up math and programming? Well, for those of you that are math wizards and into programming, it should be fairly obvious. For those of us that say, oh, hell nah, to math, this one will come as a surprise. While I was reading up on Grover's algorithm and looking at the math, I decided that I should take the time to really understand what every symbol means and how to solve the equation shown. Which brings me to this symbol right here. This is the sigma symbol, and once you understand what it means and how it can be used, you will fully understand why I stated what I did beforehand. So with that, let's get on to explaining the sigma symbol. The sigma symbol means the summation of, or in layman's terms, the sum of. Granted, it can mean more than this, but for our purposes, this is the definition we need to know. Basically, you have a number at the top of the symbol, or a combination of number and a letter. At the bottom of the symbol, we will see a letter which is set to the value of something. Then you increment that letter by 1 until you reach the value at the top of the symbol and add them all together. What does this have to do with programming? Let's showcase an example in C#. Now, before I run this, I have to make one tiny little comment, and that is since loops terminate as soon as they reach the number we specify, that we need to add one digit higher. I specified that in the for loop to add an additional loop to it to make sure we get the desired results and not confuse the user of the method itself. Now, if we look at the example problem that the definition of sigma provides, we can see the results are the same. Notice that in the example of sigma that it looks and feels just like a for loop. Let me explain. On the top of the summation operator, aka sigma, we have the number 5, which is our iterator. On the bottom, we have our initializer, which is k equals 0. So the condition is that k should equal the iterator by the end of this equation. Finally, to solve the equation, k equals 0 plus 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 equals 15. We met the condition and the loop ends and we have our results, which is 15. Well, that about does it for today. This is the Rising Phoenix Dev Jesco, signing out.